check the price.
I got it.
I made.
Da 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 da. We have a show sign. It's that Redbar show from Chicago. Welcome, everybody. All hail Emperor Darnell Trump. I gotta start the show off on a serious note here today because just hours ago, or this was last night at around 12 a.m. Patton Oswalt tweeted this out, and it sort of changed my reality on everything. So let's take a look at this real quick right now. Welcome to the show, everybody. Today's show is going to be very, very fun. We are still partying! But Patton Oswalt shared this today, and I want to share it with you guys because I think it makes a lot of sense. He says, I know this is just a small comfort, but this is how I feel. Gonna stick to this one. And he shares a poem, everybody. You guys love poems, remember? Remember how cool it is to like poems and poetry and stuff like that? This is one of the best poems I've ever read, and it sort of changed my outlook on this entire election here. So here we go. If you wear a hijab, I'll sit with you on the train. Okay, that's line number one, and all these lines go, if you do this, if you do that, okay, so I don't want to read the whole poem as if I'm serious. Obviously, we're reading this because it is the most faggoty poem we have ever seen online. So we'll go line by line. This is the first line. If you wear a hijab, I'll sit with you on the train. Have you ever heard anything more insane than that? I don't even have to continue reading the poem. Why would you want to sit with somebody with a hijab? Hijab. H-I-J-A-B. What is that? Is that the thing that the genies wear? Why would you want to sit next to a genie on the train? That seems like the... When I get on the train, I see a guy like that, I go, oh, fuck. The next line. If you're trans, I'll go to the bathroom with you. It's a real poem that Patton Oswalt and all his friends are sharing. If you're trans, I'll go to the bathroom with you. Could you imagine the stench of a transgender shit? I've never even thought about that. Imagine some fucking giant guy busting out of his dress like the Hulk and pulling up. They always wear the worst outfits, too. They get them from like thrift shops and stuff. So he wants to share a bathroom, go to the bathroom with a trans person. One of the nuttiest things I've ever heard. If you're a person of color, I'll stand with you if the cops stop you. This is what they're going to do. I don't know how that works. So Patton Oswalt's stuck in traffic, driving through downtown LA. He sees somebody, a black guy, getting arrested by the cops. He's going to jump out of his car like that cop he played on Justified. Wait, 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 officer. What's going on here? I can't wait to see them do this. Well, I got to get in our chat. Get in our chat at redbarradio.net/chat. Hajib is desert-dwelling goat fuckers. Okay, this isn't a racist show. This is an anti-poem show. Okay, we're only on the third line here. Let's get to the fourth line. If you're a person with disabilities, I'll hand you my megaphone. First of all, if you have a megaphone to hand somebody, you might need to see a few doctors. What kind of moron, what kind of psycho is walking around with a megaphone? And where do you get a megaphone? Radio Shacks are gone. Maybe they were ordering. I used to have, when we first started the show, we thought it would be funny. I had one of those little mini megaphones, the black one with the all the sounds and stuff. But I can't imagine Patton Oswalt walking around with a megaphone. Here's the next line. If you're an immigrant, I'll help you find resources. Oh, no, they don't need your help. They know where the Wi-Fi hotspots are. That's the only resource these immigrants are looking for, by the way. The Muslim ones, at least. Wi-Fi. For God knows what purpose. If you're a survivor, I'll believe you. They must be talking about rape survivors. Well, that's very nice. If you're a refugee, I'll make sure you're welcome. How? How? You have done an awful job of doing that so far. Emperor Tramp is now in charge of that. If you're a veteran, I'll take up your fight. If you're LGBTQ, I won't let anybody tell you you're broken. If you're a woman, I'll make sure you get home okay. Isn't that sexist? Why can't a woman get home okay? If you're tired, me too. I like that. A little comic relief from Patton there. If you need a hug, I've got an infinite supply. That's disgusting. And if you need me, I'll be with you. All I ask is that you be with me too. It's meltdown day here at Redbar. We're going to be going. We're dedicating the day. Okay, I know you guys are sick of politics. I know you're sick of Darnell Tremp, our new king, but you can't be sick of the meltdowns. We have experienced some of the most faggy meltdowns of our time. If we thought the SJWs, if we thought these celebrities were bad before, they've now been activated. But I want to let everybody know, you don't need to worry. I have more or less been up. I think I've had 8 hours of sleep since Tuesday. We did a 10-hour election coverage show. Check that out at redbarradio.net. That was amazing. And after that, I didn't go to bed. I stayed up for, you know, on Tuesday, I stayed up for about 32 hours straight. And I read all the posts. I couldn't stop. I wasn't even getting tired. I was just smoking weed and reading posts, laying in bed, playing with my little peep. And I do have some comforting news for all the people who think, oh, the world's ending, everybody's lost their minds. I hope you think that at least. They haven't. It's only the weak wussies that we hated before. Now they're just fully, proving us right. The sane people and even anti-Trump people are being sane about this. All the adults that you know and love, the ones that you actually like, they're cool about this. And they're scratching their heads at all the meltdowns. So we really don't have to worry. What's going on right now is we're seeing the weakest of the bunch show their true weakness. And we're seeing them for who they exactly are. So this could be a good thing. And I actually think it's a smaller number than you think. It's all the celebrities. It's all the comedians. So it makes it seem big, and then you've got all their fans. But normal people are not having meltdowns. Ricky Gervais says, they want to say it's a meltdown. So comics, yeah, it is a meltdown. It is a complete and utter tantrum. I mean, I couldn't believe my eyes on Tuesday after this, or Wednesday, whatever it was, when this started happening. I was really terrified watching all these people become activated. We're going to go over some of the best ones today. Some of the best vids. And, oh yeah, we're still celebrating over here. It's Friday. Pull out your drinks. We are still partying and having a great time from this win. Listen, I wasn't a Trump supporter. And like I said, on Wednesday, I was almost scared. And I was, my Adderall, I was on the end of my Adderall binge. And I was smoking a lot of weed. And I started, I was really posting shit like, guys, I don't think mocking these people who are having meltdowns is the answer. I was trying to be like real adult about it. That lasted maybe 3 hours. And I don't know where I went from there to here, but I am in full, we need to embarrass the fuck out of these people mode. And today is going to be a day spent drinking, partying, smoking, and just really making fun of these psychotic people. Patton, I'm sorry, you are psychotic. You know, I know they might have fooled people, you know, but I gotta let you know, anybody who spends their life, dedicates their lives, and gets to these places that these actors, these actresses, and comedians have gotten to, they're frauds to begin with. You gotta go through a lot of fraudulent steps to get where these people got to. And you gotta go through a lot of, You know, I was watching American Horror Story Roanoke, My Roanoke Nightmare, and they have this, somebody pull up a picture of Lee. They have a black woman on the show named Lee, and she is very fucking weird looking, and I'm going, how did she even become an actress? Like, all of a sudden, one day, this black woman, Lee, just went into a casting office and said, hello, my name is Lee. I would like to try out for the position of being an actress. And they're like, yeah, okay. I mean, to be able to get to these positions, you got to be a nut to begin with. And I think what we got used to is listening to these people and thinking they're... Sorry about this. I'm trying to open my wine here. Got a new bottle. $6.99, fellas. You know, we got so used to listening to these people that we thought they were normal, but they're anything but normal. The same thing with the media. What you've got in the media, again, what kind of fucking crazy person dedicates their life to journalism and works through those ranks? I mean, sure, there's probably some good people, but they're not normal people by any means. And I think that's where we make the biggest mistake. We're assuming that these are people, but they're not people. They're entertainers. At the end of the day, these people want the spotlight. I mean, imagine, you know, turn on your local news. How did those fucks get that job? Who is hiring them? Maria Menaka. Have you seen these people? You can't tell if they're Indian, Chinese, or whatever. So we're going to be going through all of them today, and I think it's very important to make a list, and let's really keep an eye on the ones that are crazy, and hopefully, you know, what I'm really hoping comes out of all this is that they become separated from the people we trust, okay? So I hope after this year we go, oh yeah, we don't listen to Amy Schumer anymore. Amy Schumer's crazy. We don't listen to Lita Dunham. They don't get a say anymore. I mean, they could talk all they want, but the world needs to know those are the unstable people, okay? And they've really mucked up this whole thing. So whether or not you voted for Trump, whether or not you voted for Hillary, you know, I see my follower counts are dropping. So there are secret people getting mad, you know, and we saw it. You've seen your Facebooks. You've seen your tweets. You've been shocked. All we've been doing, the only thing people have been doing since Tuesday is either crying about the Trump loss, crying about the Trump win, complaining about the Trump win, or if you're one of us, laughing and taking screenshots. You probably have, I don't know if you've saved your screenshot, you probably have 17,000 screenshots from the last 3 days alone, if you're anything like me. That's all I've been doing. Watching, laughing, mocking, and I thought about it for a while, and I think what's best to do, again, really point out the insane ones. You've got Bill Maher tonight. If you saw Bill Maher last week, wait till you see him tonight. Last week on his show, I mean, he was yelling at everybody. He wouldn't let anybody talk. He was so very concerned. So I can't imagine what he's going to be like tonight. And don't unfriend these people. Don't be like them. We need to see what they're up to. It's the only way to get kind of a grasp on what's really going on. If you only follow the Proud Boys, believe me, you are not really getting the full information on what's going on. So you got to follow them all. Don't remove people. Laugh at them. Enjoy it. It's a lot of fun. So I want to start. Let's start with the videos because those really bring me to life. And then we'll read some of my favorite posts. But I need you to see what I've seen. I need the whole world to see what I've seen. I think you're starting to, though. I think for the first time, really, everybody, not just us, is starting to see these people for who they truly are. And we are going to laugh at them today. But we got to watch Bill Maher tonight. That's going to be a good one. Yeah. Let's start with Pete Davidson. Why not? And we're going to go through them all. Handler, Conan. I mean, this is one of the better days of my life. I hope you're having a great time. Shout outs to everybody who came out today. If you're watching live on Compound, get in our chat as well. We're going to need your help coming up with the best. I want to see the riot footage. I want to see meltdown footage, your favorite posts. Keep your links to yourself right now because I've got a bunch to start with, but I'm going to ask you for them later. And yeah, we'll go over all the best ones. Let's start with Pete Davidson. Did I give out the chat? Redbarradio.net/chat. Shout outs. And if you're listening, if this is the only, like, if you're from Compound and this is the third show you've heard, we've done so much bonus content since our last show. We did the Jack Buckby special, Proud Boys Jack Buckby. We did a full attack on him that was very successful. That's up at redbarradio.net. It's a joyous time. And then we did the election special. We did 10 straight hours, and it was, I know you're over the election, but we had a great time with that, and you should watch that. It's not throwaway content. Let's watch Pete Davidson. You know him from SNL. Did you know he's dating Larry David's daughter? He dates Larry David's daughter now, Cassie David, who all the comedians, they go, she's so hot. Louis J. Gomez, she's so banging. She has a non-fat body. She has a fit body. It's fine. She has the face of every Jew Larry David has ever placed eyes on in his whole life. It's like every Jew Larry David's ever seen throughout his life was cataloged somewhere. And then like a weird science type of deal, it made a baby with the face of the combination of every Jew he's ever looked at. Very, very ugly. But Pete Davidson is like marrying Larry David's daughter. He's on SNL now. He's a comedian. And I really hope that Larry David isn't lost in this group of people. Wait till you hear Pete Davidson. Let's roll it. This is from his Instagram. Let's check this out.
I cannot believe this bullshit. It almost... Something's up. Something's wrong. And
cheers, guys.
Up.
We're partying.
And I don't think this was very fair. But basically what you're telling me is you won't let this sweet old lady be president, who's nobody's more qualified than her to be president. She's been helping the whole entire world for 30 years. And you're not going to let her be president because she's a woman? I mean, you're going to let fucking rapist, someone who doesn't even know how to fucking read, someone who doesn't know anything about politics, someone who's fucking racist, a piece of shit, grab him by the pussy, all on cat. Are you serious?
This is real.
This is fucked up. This is one of the... This is the worst thing that's ever happened to me.
His dad died in 9/11.
This is the worst thing that's ever happened to me. And what a fuck you to Obama. Way to, like, really ruin everything he fucking did for the last 8 years.
Yeah, that was the point. That's the point.
I'm disappointed.
So there he is. Okay, there's Pete Davidson. 157,000 views. This guy's dad, literally, like, his whole career is based around this idea that his dad died in 9/11, which is very, very sad. And he's this young comic. Yeah, my dad died in 9/11. He said twice, this is the worst thing that's ever happened in his whole life. This is the very worst thing that's happened. His people don't really like it. They're all saying you need to grow up. So that's what I want to keep in mind. We don't have a reason to panic. I know on day one, we really thought, oh, fuck, this is going to get really bad. And while it is getting really bad, it's waking up all of the rational people. And all the rational people out there, whether they hate Trump or not, are going, oh, wait, no, he's not a rapist. He's not a killer. I mean, now they're just, Trump is a rapist. He is a... Do you think... You know, I tweeted, it seems so simple. If Trump really was Hitler, if he really was this end-of-the-world guy, regardless of how tradition works, Barack Obama wouldn't be shaking his hand and having a peaceful talk with him. Or maybe he would, but if I was Barack Obama and I really believed Trump was Hitler... And they said, well, what are you going to do? I'd be like, fuck it. I'm not shaking his hand. That's Hitler. No, sorry. It's not happening. Yeah, I get that's a little unprofessional. But I don't shake Hitler's hand. So the fact that these people all of a sudden are now treating Trump as if he's just a regular candidate that won. Even Megyn Kelly is covering it like, well, congratulations on the Trump presidency. They sure did work hard. And what are you talking about? This guy was Hitler. You can't. You know, they didn't realize what Hillary and Obama and all these people didn't realize is what Obama and Hillary were doing was business as usual, politics as usual, where you trash the other side that you're fighting to no end. However, this time around, what they didn't realize is all their supporters didn't know that it was just bullshit BS. They truly believed that Darnell Trump, our emperor, is Hitler. So you scared them to death, and now he won, and they still believe all the stuff you said, and now you guys have moved on to, oh, yeah, he's fine. Yeah, we'll swear him in. We'll shake hands with him. It's pretty cool. So a little messed up, you know, I don't know. And if I was, you know, spent my whole campaign like Hillary Clinton saying this guy is the devil, well, I wouldn't congratulate the devil. I know that's what tradition does, but, you know, traditionally you didn't say this guy was Hitler. Your opponent was Hitler. So shouldn't Hillary Clinton and Trump and all the people just say absolutely not? I don't care. Yeah, I don't care if you're, I'm supposed to. I'm not shaking his hand. I'm not welcoming him. But they do, you know, proving that they were, you know, just talking shit to win an election. They're greatly respected. They need to come out and say, guys, we were just trying to win. OK. And same with the media, because what you've got right now, these people truly Pete Davidson, you know, you're done. You're throughs. Anybody who truly, truly is scared and trembling that Trump won. And we're going to read these. Wait till you see these. If you are truly scared, I don't know what I could do for you. I mean, I think you truly, truly need to have your parents make that doctor's appointment for you this week, and get some real, real help. Let's go to Kumail Nanjiani, one of my favorites on Twitter this week. You might know Kumail as the Indian comic who they use because he's Indian. Yeah, that's why you have a career. Here's Kumail Nanjiani. You know what's so funny? On the top of his Twitter, there is a giant banner that says The Meltdown with Jonah Ray and Kumail Nanjiani. That's the name of their show that they do in LA. Couldn't be more fitting right now. Kumail Nanjiani has been freaking out. He's a comedian. You've seen this guy, this Indian. You've seen him on Portlandia. You've seen him. Oh, Silicon Valley. Everyone knows him now. He used to be a comic here in Chicago. I used to pal around with these people. Him, TJ Milstein, all these guys. He's, in fact, Kumail's been on the show before. You know what he said? This is what Kumail said when he was on our show midway through. I can't believe that people actually listen to this. Huh, yeah, you can't believe it? Huh. Now look what they're listening to. So I want to show you Kumail's tweet starting on November 8th. First, he posted a picture of him and all of his friends. Actually, very, very sad. Very sad and crying. These aren't jokes. Okay, here's my favorite. I'll be okay, but I'm terrified for my family. My mom, my dad, my uncle, they all live over this. They live all over this country. Why the fuck are you terrified for your Indian family? Did I miss something? Did Trump run a campaign saying, oh, and by the way, the Indians, especially the parents of Indian actors, we must pull them from their home. Where are they getting this fear from? So I'll be okay, but I'm terrified for my family, my mom, my dad, my uncle. They all live all over this country. And he continues, if you're a guy and you post a tweet, day one. That's what he posts. Day one. Yeah, is it that bad? Nothing happened except you guys crying all over Twitter. Listen to this. Here's a great one from Kumail. He's one of my favorites because he's got a real thing going on with his Indian mother. Tried to get my mom to stop crying using words I don't have. Wait. I wanted the sad one. Tried to get my mom to stop crying using words I don't have. Oh, that is so fucking sad. Can somebody please help Kumail Nanjiani's mother get through this? Who the fuck would go bother some 70-year-old Indian woman who has been living here her whole life? Why would anybody be bothering her now? So you think because Trump wins, they truly believe this, that because Trump won, everybody who voted for Trump is just going to start attacking anybody who's not white. This is real. This is coming from adult people. They're not kidding around. They're not joking. They truly believe this fear. Imagine being that scared. That would be fucked up. Like, imagine if you truly believed that. Like, imagine being this guy and going, I've been on the phone with my mom. I mean, what should we do? I don't know. You might want to use some of your TV money to hire some security, Kumail, if you truly believe that. How fucking terrifying would it be to truly believe that your family is now in danger? And that's what's happening right now. I want to read more Kumail tweets. Guys, I just had cold water for the first time in 2 days, and it was still delicious, so there's that. I've never read that one. Here's another one about his mom, 18 hours ago. Every text from my mom is the most heartbreaking thing I've ever read. Until the next text from my mom. Wow. So he's using his Twitter joke writing skills now to just say sad stuff. You need to send your mom to a mental institution if you can't get her to stop crying. Okay? And the fact that any one of your friends would encourage this is the most irresponsible thing I think I've ever heard. Let's keep going. She shouldn't have to feel like this. It's fucking unfair. Well, I did not mean that, Kumail. Now, on our election special, I did yell something about how we should nuke all Indians. That was a joke. I wonder if they understand the jokes from the reality. Here's one from Kumail. Grab them by the pussy. Half the country votes for him. Ban Muslim. Half the country still can't find anything positive about these. I don't even know what that means. And here's his latest one. I've always believed there is no such thing as inherent goodness of people. I've always believed there is no such thing as the inherent goodness of people. Morality comes from a good and just society. I'm scared. This is why we can't have Indians living amongst us. They obviously do not get the fabric of reality. And what kind of person, you know, these are the type of people all year preaching about how good they are and how great they are. And then all you've got for your followers, all these people who are so scared, this is how you pump them up. This is what you tell your lost followers. Believe me, if you're a fan of this guy, you're a little cuckoo. And now you've got him saying, you have every right to be scared. My mom can't even stop crying. The Indians even cry? Imagine the stench of an Indian tear. I would say it must come out, yeah. A little yellowed. So that's just Kumail. And we're going to go through the list. Chelsea Handler had a great breakdown on her show the other night. Guess we'll play that. But we definitely want everybody to be celebrating with us today in our chat at redbarradio.net/chat. Share your favorite moments. We're going to go over them all. I want to look at all the best posts, all the best tweets, the riots, the fights, and all the best videos. And I want to get them all in one place here today. I think it's super important. So let's make a list. So far, we've got somebody write these down as we go, because we need to make a watch list. Pete Davidson, Kumail Nanjiani, Pat Nosloff. We've got those guys. Let's do Chelsea Handler. Yeah. And she had on this comic, Nikki Glaser. Nikki Glaser was on. She's not in this clip, but Nikki was on and actually came on Chelsea Handler's Netflix show wearing funeral clothes with like that widower shit in her face. But here's Chelsea Handler, who has a Netflix show. I don't know who's watching this show. I've watched a bunch of episodes. See, I go out of my way. I make sure that I watch all this stuff. I watched a bunch of episodes of Chelsea's new Netflix show. It's unwatchable. You know, she really is an ass. She's a female fool. And I remember when Chelsea Handler back, she started with her, she wasn't even a political person. And then when Trump started running, she saw everybody was doing anti-Trump stuff. So she thought it would be really funny to do a Trump pinata. And this was the downfall of creativity. I couldn't believe it. I go, did you think that you're like the first person to think of a Trump pinata for the Mexicans to hit? So here she is. She's talking to Senator Barbara Boxer, a deranged old woman. And this is from her show the other day. Check this out. This is some good, good, good stuff. I hope we're having a great time, guys.
You know, it's the future.
I want to thank all the millennial voters who registered through our Rock the Vote thing. We registered something like 7,000 unregistered
voters. Whoa, 7,000 people. Wow.
Getting out there. Ultimately, last night, I mean, I know you're close with Hillary. You guys were related, right? Or are related. I don't know if relation expires. But do you, have you spoken to her?
No, I did not want to speak with her at this point. I intend to actually sit down. I like to write. I have too much to say.
Yeah. Same.
And I want to think about it.
Here comes a tear. Watch this.
What? No.
Look at Chelsea.
I know for a
crying.
Woman, as a woman, it feels so sexist. And I think
that's because you're deranged. That's because you don't know how to think. If you're a woman out there and you think this is because of sexism, you got another thing coming. Half of it is, though. And I need you to know this, women. Sexism is a thing because it's real. You do need to take a passenger seat to us. We are in charge. You don't have the story yet. You know, wait till consciousness is uploaded into the machine, and then maybe you could run for president. But until now, you are crying on national TV about the loss of Hillary Clampton. And by the way, if Hillary is so great, why did she get basically the exact same amount of votes as the very worst person ever? Okay, these weren't a lot of votes. So if Donald Trump is the biggest monster, the worst person ever, why did Hillary get the same amount of votes? Shouldn't that say something about Hillary? It's not like a ton of people went out and voted for Hillary, only the insane. So it's not like she's that great of a woman.
Message that I want to like spread out to other women is exactly what you're saying, is not to give up. Sorry.
No, please give up.
Camera, but is not to give up because this is so important. And it's easy to say, throw in the towel and that we're going to leave.
No,
or I'm going to move to Spain because I want to move to Spain. I really, really want to move to Spain right now. And everyone.
Good luck buying all that shit in your house from Amazon.com when you live in Spain. I'd like to see Chelsea Handler get by in Spain. You know, you think, how good do you think that's going to work out in Spain when all the stores close at 8?
One of my offices, like, you have a responsibility. You have a voice and you need to use it and you have to be here.
Please don't do that. Stay home. But give up.
When you're talking about stuff like the Electoral College and we're talking about, you know, rules, just the language, I think, that he used in this candidacy, in my mind, should be, you know, that should disqualify somebody from being a candidate. If you're caught lying on camera 3 times in a row,
no.
If you're referring to a woman's genitalia, you know, like those are non-presidential things, unpresidential
things. How about never showing your tax returns, the only one in modern history? It's ridiculous.
How about, or paying taxes? How about starting to pay taxes?
Yes, we all know all of the Trump stuff. I love how every time they bring them up, it's like they've got to reiterate all the, what about the grab the pussies? You lost. It's hilarious. The entire world is laughing at you guys this week.
Taxes.
Good point.
All the cool people.
Paying the contractors that built your property. Instead of walking away and leaving them to sue you to get paid. But we just can't go back to the darkness.
No, I know. I know.
We have to go
right.
Toward the light.
Look at that.
But to go towards the light, I want to be hopeful. I have to be hopeful. We all have
yes.
to be hopeful about
yes.
what could possibly good
yes.
could come from it.
Let me tell you. When you say, I want to leave, I want to go. Of course, it's the flight syndrome. We fought now.
No, that's not flight syndrome. No. There's no flight syndrome. It's insanity. Anybody who would want to leave America over this is crazy. So, and now we're seeing them. We're seeing them live and uncensored, the breakdowns. And history will be on our side with this as far as the mental breakdowns go. Because there's, again, a lot of anti-Trump people not having breakdowns. You know, Bill Burr, Conan O'Brien, he could not contain himself. Conan O'Brien, who I, you know, again, I've been so foolish to believe that maybe these people know what they're doing. You know, I thought Conan was a good guy. Conan O'Brien was shaken to tears on his monologue. He just couldn't believe it. And then he had Bill Burr on the same show after having this really heartfelt monologue. And Bill Burr basically just belittled everything Conan said. It's like he wasn't even listening. Bill Burr just came on. He's like, what's everyone complaining about? I'd show the clip, but it's a little boring. But the rational guys that we've all thought were rational, they're still rational. And it's really the ones who kind of don't know what they're talking about that are flipping out. Yeah, this is pretty much the SJW 9/11. So yeah, if you thought this stuff would go away, no. They have been completely activated. And now all the lies the media told them and all that stuff you did to win the election, Hillary, all that stuff, what you didn't realize is that these people were that dumb. You didn't think that they would actually believe it because you're so used to just saying shit about the other candidate. And then you saw that this was picking up. Oh, they hate racists. Okay, let's keep going with that. And you truly got these people to be very fearful. And now they're terrified. I don't understand. How do they see when Hillary Clinton gave that acceptance speech, when they see Barack Obama with them, don't they go, well, this doesn't add up with my crying. So they must be very, 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 very confused. I want to keep playing some of the best meltdowns today. And then we've got a great one from this YouTuber, TommyNC2010. He gives his take, and it's a little bit different than all the celebrities, but I'll do that one in a little bit. Ooh, Brian Redban was crying? Joe Rogan's guy, Brian Redban? Nobody will be able to find this because it was a Periscope, and I think it's deleted now. Brian Redban went on Periscope after the election, okay, Death Squad, crying. He was in the passenger seat of a car, drunk, bawling. I don't know what to do. This is so fucked up. This is so fucked up. It's so fucked up. What the fuck is wrong with Brian Redban? Joe Rogan is on our side. Joe Rogan did a show right after the election. He goes, have you seen the people complaining and crying? What the fuck? So, again, the smart people know what's up. But Brian Redban being in tears, I almost can't let that go. I feel like if you cried for any reason, if you cried tears of joy, you're a faggot too. If you cried based on the results of this election, you should no longer be listened to. Okay? You need help. You got to figure out yourself. All I watched was a bunch of people who haven't, they spent so much time on this election that they forgot to work on themselves. You know, they told us what to do for 2 years, for 4 years. I mean, this isn't about the election. It's about this whole telling us what to do. And they jumped on to that as a way to never have to work on their own problems. It's so much easier to just tell everybody else what to do. And now you've seen they lost. They can't control themselves. If anyone could find the clip of Brian Redban crying, I couldn't believe it. I thought he was cooler than that. I thought he would be like, eh, come on, guys. What can you do? You should. But nope. He had a meltdown. There was some Chinese girl crying. And I don't think they're faking it. You know, I think this is part of the scariness. They're not faking it. You can't, like, especially Brian, you can't fake crying about this. You know, I guess some real sick SJWs, but we wondered this. Are the SJWs faking it or do they really believe this? I think they really believe it. I think that's what we're seeing this entire time. These people truly, truly believed what everyone was saying, not just about Trump, but about the whole, you know, everybody being under some sort of vicious attack, and it's just not happening. You know, it just hasn't happened, and it's not going to happen now that Trump won. Although, I got to say, I do feel like I'm allowed to just talk shit on the internet now, finally. You know, I'm lost in the crowd. They got better, bigger problems than me now. But I felt like mid last year, it was like, fuck, man, got to be careful what you say. Remember, Twitter was banning everybody. They were banning. They banned Milo. They banned me a bunch. Now I feel like Twitter, maybe that's why Twitter got rid of Vine. They needed the money for the new council coming in with this Trump, because right now they got a lot of work to do on Twitter. Jesus, Redban is such a bitch. Yeah, join our chat, redbarradio.net/chat. Let's see. Redban's Periscope is still up. Let's see. Is this the one, though? Because he had a bunch. The worst night ever. Brian Redban, Joe Rogan's helper. Brian, I got to say, dude, I liked you. I did like you. I hope, you know, we could still hang out, and I need your listeners, so it would be nice if you, I once got on your show, but you can't be crying in public about a Trump win. I'm sorry. Got to throw you under the bus. Here we go. Let's see. He's in a car right now. Okay, here he is. This is Periscope. It's a little dark, but you'll be able to hear him when he starts. He's in his car.
I'm only making this video for the people that hate me, that are also Trump fans. Like, those two things together.
We're
oh my
drinking.
God. You have to have the greatest night in your whole entire life.
Yeah, we.
Watching this video, right? So I want you to feel.
This is madness. This is a 42-year-old guy.
Because I know I don't. I feel
Joe Rogan's helper.
Like this weird, horrible feeling that hit me. Like, the only time I remember feeling this, like, fucked up was.
The only time.
After watching 9/11.
Wow!
Like, that was the last time. And I remember just walking around in a daze, just going like, wow.
I think you're retarded, bro. Happened. I think you're stupid.
Same shit just happened. It's fucked up. So I want you guys to, like,
we're smoking.
Love this shit. Like, make fun of me. Make a gift. I don't give a fuck.
We are.
I want you guys to know that I'm just really sad. Like, I'm... Wow. I feel like we took a huge step backwards. I feel like race and...
Listen to this guy. 42 years
religion,
old, I think.
It's just like religion and race just got back into being a thing. Like, I love
religion
Obama.
And race just got back into being
Obama
a thing. 42-year-old man
wouldn't leave the house, and
yeah,
then like Trump tried to go come in, and then like Obama,
listen to this guy. You know,
like, no, you can't come in. Like,
he's such
like,
a nice like a, guy. I don't like to make fun of him, but I mean, eventually, could we tell the 42-year-old man that he's acting like a retard? You know, it's gone on long enough, and I know it's always been cute, but this is the problem with America. The problem isn't Trump. The problem isn't policies. The problem is retards, and we've got a lot of them on all sides. Everywhere you look, corrupted brains, minds made of mush. These women were drinking while these people were in their wombs. I do believe fetal alcohol syndrome has a lot to do with this, but it's time to start. Stop saying, Brian Redbar's so great. Brian Redbar's so great. You know, he's talking to a tremendous amount of people. And when you have a retard who they respect because Joe Rogan says he's great, everybody says he's great, now they think he's great too. And they think, oh, well, hey, if Brian's acting like this, maybe this is what it's really about. So you've got retards convincing who could be maybe normal people to panic. And I think it's completely dangerous. And I think if you're slow, that's fine. But we all need to know it. You know, we all need, it needs to be verified. It can't just be, oh, no, Brian's great. and then do this. This is a 42-year-old man. There is no excuse. And I want to play all these to remind people that there is zero excuse for this. Even if it was the very worst thing in the world, there is no excuse to be acting like this. I've gone through many worst things in the world, and I've never given up, and I've never sat there and whined that there's no hope. I figure out a plan B immediately. And any man that isn't doing that should not be in charge of anybody else. They shouldn't have cars. They shouldn't have platforms. People shouldn't be listening to them. That being said, let's listen to all of them today and laugh and laugh and laugh.
Trump, like a fight or something. That would have been great.
Listen to what he's listening to, too.
So anyways, we're on our way home right now, and we're going to do some VR.
That'll help. Some PlayStation VR.
Trump, President Trump. I can't believe I said that with my dirty mouth.
He's not kidding.
President Trump. Post-President Trump. President Trump. President Donald Trump. So we're doing some post-Donald Trump.
This is a man.
We're doing a post.
He can't put sentences together.
VR.
He's so upset.
Let's not stay in this road. Let's go to the Sony PlayStation VR.
And we have a special guest.
Not only do we have Rye Dune, who's in the back.
Hey, guys.
Rye, what do you think about all this? You've been quiet all night.
Oh, my God. I didn't know he was here. This is Ryan Dune, one of the most famous Vine celebrities out there. And for 2 years, I have been meaning to do an entire series on this guy. It might be, today might be too much. Ryan Dune is the most famous person on Vine. I'm so glad Vine closed down. Ryan Dune is cringe god, 2015-2016 champion. And you don't even know it yet. If I were to start with the Ryan Dune stuff, it would probably be a 5-week series, multiple discs. It would cost thousands of dollars to even stream. We'd be eating up so much bandwidth. But I got to show you his stuff. He got famous on Vine for doing a Jay-Z impression.
It's your boy.
Makes me sick. And the stuff I've seen Ryan Dune do, again, another adult. These are adults. If you know who Ryan Dune is, press one. If you know who Ryan Dune is and you've been waiting for him to be exposed, press one. I just want to see if anyone knows, because I know I get into some inside shit here, but promise me this guy's a loser. Had no idea he was in the back of the car.
I feel bad.
You don't want to say anything, right?
No, I'll say stuff.
But like, what are you thinking right now?
I'm thinking I feel embarrassed and ashamed.
I feel embarrassed, ashamed.
I feel bad about being white.
I haven't watched this whole thing. Ryan Dune. Not Ryan Dunn. No. Not Ryan Dunn from Jackass. Rye Dune. I think that's his username on Vine. He is a... You know, he's like a YouTuber guy, but he does Vine. So anybody who does Vine is cringe god to me. I mean, there's nothing gayer than that. He just said he's ashamed to be white. Okay, so people do know Ryan Dune. They're all pressing one. Wow, you know about Ryan Dune. Not Ryan Dunn from Jackass. Ryan Dune. Don't press two. I didn't ask for any twos, guys. Just ones. Oof, you know, I made a mistake. I got to pee real bad. We're going to have to take a pee break in a little bit. He's in the back of a lot of cars. Oh, yeah. Also, as a man, never sit in the back of a car, even if it's the only ride you have and you're stranded and your phone's dead. I would say don't even sit passenger as a guy. Okay, let's go back into this. He said he is ashamed to be white.
Like, I'm going to be judged.
Oh, he has like 8 million followers on Vine. Very, very famous on Vine.
Being white?
Yeah.
That might be like dangerous to say, but...
I feel the same way. I feel like racist shit's taken... Like, we went backwards. Like, race shit's going to get worse.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. And
unbelievable.
Hey, on the record, can I be like on the black side, please?
Wow.
Please, can, is there a thing?
Yeah,
can
you we, know what? Like, I think they do that? Need to come over to Chicago and come check out the black side. Come with me. I'll show you. Come with me and you'll see. It's a world of men wearing bandanas. They have braids, some of them dyed, and their eyes are like zombies. They don't care about life. They shoot anything and everything because they weren't raised by any man or woman. They're animals. They don't get it. I love black people. You know, there's nobody more hip-hop that's white than me, you know. I like sane black people. And I even like the Shooters. Ooh. I do. As long as they admit to it. But don't pretend like it's a better world, you know. Come over. You know, he wants to be part of the black part of society. They're better. And they are. You know, they're great. Black people aren't bad. But you have to be honest about... You know, they tried to, Trump brought up the shootings in Chicago, and because of this campaign, Hillary like rolled her eyes and the whole, every Hillary supporter went, oh yeah, I'm sure Chicago's really dangerous. Come on. Dude, I live here every day on the news. These aren't fake stats. Gene Wilder just came back to life. I would like to dig up Gene Wilder and decapitate him. Let's go back to this. And again, this is just one of millions of people just losing their minds. And I hope you're not watching this today going, wow, Mike drank the Kool-Aid. He's a Trump supporter. He supports the hatred. Well, you know what? I'm sick of defending myself. I do. I am one of the most... No, I'm like, you know, I'm just being true, bro. You know, I don't... I only hate people if they're... doing something wrong. And if you want to talk about, you know, oh, Mike's racist, watch episodes from 2003 until now. I guarantee you most, probably 80% of the people I go after, white. So look at that. You know, you don't see, I don't go after black people because they're black. And that's what they want you to believe. They want you to believe that if you're even okay with the Trump win, if you did not vote for Hillary, if you weren't one of those 59 million people, which, believe me, that number is rigged, but if you weren't one of those 59 million people, that you're racist now. That's what they're saying. And we shouldn't be insulted by that. Racism, being racist is normal now. More people are racist. There's 300 and what, 40 million people, so minus 59 million. Whatever that number may be, those are all racists and sexists. So I guess that means it's right. Trump's nice. Yeah, you can't believe any of this stuff. This is all a giant misunderstanding. And I say that, usually I say that it's a big joke. This really is. I mean, we all watched it unfold. And we all watched these people get completely suckered. And what's really hard about this is that that's what they think happened to us. They're all saying that we've been suckered. So I don't think this is going to get cleaned up anytime soon. All we could hope for is they keep embarrassing themselves. And all we could hope for is that people see. Okay? Mike loves Kanye. How could he be racist? Exactly. You know how much money I have given to Kanye West? More than I've given to David Duke. David Duchovny. I'm sorry. Okay, let's go back to these guys panicking. This is Brian Redman, Joe Rogan. And Joe Rogan made fun of this behavior on his show. So I'm doing nothing different than what Joe Rogan does. I also started taking jiu-jitsu. That's all I do.
Mexican or black, whatever.
I honestly feel like just by me being white, people might assume that I'm a Trump supporter.
Right.
But that's a very narrow-minded thing, which most people won't assume.
These are adults.
But as a white person, I'm like, fuck. Please don't assume I...
This is what they're worried. Please don't assume I voted for Trump. Please.
I just feel bad for myself and...
I just hate everything so much.
I hate everybody so much.
It sucks.
You know what really sucks too? Is social media.
Oh.
Social media really sucks. Because you almost feel protected because you're following people that you like. Like-minded people. So you follow so many people that are like-minded. And they're like-minded for a reason, because you all have the same beliefs. So you think everything's fine. Oh no.
Mm-mm.
This Trump guy is hilarious, but we're gonna be okay. Because all your tweets are like, fuck Trump, this Trump, Trump, Saturday Night Live is Trump, any Kimmel's Trump, like everything you watch on TV is anti-Trump. But you start believing that everyone around you and everything you know is on your side, but then you realize that there's more dumb people in the world than there is friends on Twitter. Like,
what?
There's a reason why anywhere you go, like if Walmart puts a fucking store anywhere in the world.
And Brian, I want you to know the chat's lighting up. This is insane. People are writing LMAO. Still don't know what that means. This is sad. This is amazing. This is gold. This is what we think of you. And I want that to be the mainstream this year. Us laughing in their faces. And it's so tough, though, because they really do think that we're just the racist Trump supporters. And that's what we're going to do. So we need... And Bill Burr, that's why I like what Bill Burr's doing. They all trust Bill Burr. I mean, he really is their god. When he speaks, it doesn't matter what kind of comedian you are, they listen. They obey Burr. And unlike Louis C.K., I think I called this years ago, when Louis C.K. first started becoming super famous, Bill Burr was always the guy that we said would hold it together. And he could have really, you know, Bill Burr's got a black wife. And I'm going to show you this other comic with a black wife who had a complete and utter meltdown and blocked me because of this Trump win. Bill Burr has the same type of black wife. And, you know, Bill Burr could have easily gone along with all this horse shit. And he is, you know, aggravated, to say the least, with how they're acting. He's really coming out against them, which I didn't think he would do. I thought he would kind of keep his mouth shut. But it's good. I hope they listen to Bill Burr. I hope they see. I hope they listen to Rogan, who says this is ridiculous. So it is good that we have some people that they respect. You know, it's not about do we respect them. We need people they respect to be mocking them. I got a piece so
there
fucking
bad. There are people
bad.
That are going to go to it that are not thinking the same shit you're thinking.
Most of the country does not think the way that we think.
No, it
They're
sucks.
Mostly...
It makes me want to get in a car accident.
Wow.
Just so I have half, like 30% of my brain functions.
Somebody in the chat, by the way, in the Periscope chat says, I really want to move to Europe. Good. Move to Europe. You're going to have a real fun time with all that ancient gold furniture that everybody's got. Did you hear Brian Redban? He said, I really want to get into a car accident. That would be better than this. And I've heard that many times. I mean, I've watched hundreds of men say that they would die. They want to die because of this. This is a mental disability.
Just so I can figure it out.
So you can fit in.
Dude, what if you get in a car accident and you go, I get it now. All right, let's do it.
Toe, drop into a wall.
Hey, no.
Telephone pole, straight ahead.
No, there's a car in front of it.
I am really embarrassed and ashamed. And I feel bad. I fucking feel bad as a white person. Because, honestly.
Yeah, it just sucks.
I don't know. It's like, because I know people are going to judge this as, like, racist white people.
Oh, no. I'm not even reading the comments because I want people that love Trump and that believe in Trump and his shit, I want them to fucking post it. I want to watch this later and see.
42-year-old guy. I want to keep everybody remembering that.
Against you guys. I promise you, I'm not. maybe I'm the stupid one.
Yes, but yeah,
I really
maybe.
Want
yeah.
to know, like, what you guys are thinking. And unfortunately,
I don't think you would get it.
Now I feel like we have to do some horrible shit just to be saved, I guess.
Saved?
You know what I mean?
Like, you are like dumb, someone says in the chat. Yeah, good.
And then
I'm scared,
like,
says another guy.
So that's good.
Maybe this is a bad shit.
Yeah. I think we all need bad shits in our life. Like, look, man, I've been going through bad shit for a couple years now. And
Red Band sniffs Hillary's farts.
If there's a light, then it's a positive story. And hopefully there's always going to be a light. Hopefully there's always going to be a positive.
Oh, Brian, someone writes.
But man.
Listen to this guy. 42 years old. He runs Death Squad. I should have worn my Death Squad shirt today. Ryan Dune in the back crying.
What do you think, Toe?
Oh my God. Elisa Lamb behind the wheel. Brian Redband's Asian girlfriend.
It just feels like a really bad joke.
He only dates Asians now.
It feels like a bad joke.
It feels like a bad joke taken too far.
It feels like a bad joke.
A lot of people are going to get hurt.
You should be more worried about right. Slender Man, miss.
Do you think it, overall it's going to be a...
Aw, she's so sad, someone writes.
I think so, eventually. It's just one blip in anything.
Oh, no, they were being real. Aw, she's so sad.
But
in my mind, I couldn't think of any other comment than, aw, she's so sad. Brian Redband dates, you know, and you got to watch out for these guys. These guys who are addicted to... Japanimation and Asians, there's a sickness in them. And Brian Redband is dating one of the most Asian-y women you could ever lay eyes on. And she's not very smart. I've watched her speak. There is really nothing coming out of that mouth. And nothing being seen with those eyes. So, she is terrified. And again, if your tiny little Asian girlfriend is driving your 42-year-old ass around in a car while you cry about Trump winning, you might be a complete faggot.
Like, everything neutralizes eventually, but it just, you know, it just sucks that we're here now with it.
It just sucks that we have to deal with it.
It just sucks that some... Yeah, it just feels like a bad joke.
A bad joke.
You know.
Yeah.
Like, racism isn't funny. Racism isn't funny.
This has nothing to do with racism, Trump winning.
It just feels like a bad...
Knowing the guy is a liar is not funny. You want to trust the president. You want it to be your dad almost. You just want to be like, I trust my dad, the president.
It feels like a nightmare.
She looks like an alien.
Like a bad acid trip that should have just stayed in your trip, and the next minute you're like, holy shit, that was fucking crazy, and you're recovering from it. But this is in the fucking government now, and it's like... Yeah. It's like a nightmare come true.
A nightmare come true. Yeah.
To be in LA and to think different than all you guys watching this in the middle, what they call...
They're all saying, you trust wicked Hillary?
Like the states.
Wicked Hillary.
Like, yeah.
The establishment era is over. Look at these people.
But if
we really have a retard problem.
If you look at... All the analytics.
Analytics. He doesn't know the word. He doesn't give a
shit.
But
it's so amazing. No. Just look at tonight when you go home. Look at the blue on the map. Guess what is the most popular fucking...
Enough with him.
States for comedy, open minds... Like, it matches up almost exactly with what states Clinton, except for, like, Ohio.
This is very sad and pathetic. I want to let it play out. It's almost over. That's why I'm letting it go. And then I got to take a real big hot urine. California's on suicide watch.
No. I'm more scared of Mike Pence, so we have to keep Donald Trump alive as long as possible.
We can't
Mike Pence is the scariest person in the whole entire world.
Scariest
Hopefully,
person.
Like Obama. Like,
more than
I
Jeffrey
don't
Dahmer.
Even know who are Biden? Is Biden?
Yeah. Listen.
All right. Holy shit.
Is Biden
like,
the vice president?
I had president? No idea who even our vice president was.
Listen to this guy.
Biden seems pretty cool.
He has no idea who the vice president is, but he knows all about this election. These are the guys you got talking. These are the guys you got scaring the rest of the world. We got to even it out somehow, but it's going to be hard to because, again, celebrities have the biggest platform, but celebrities are like this. They've all got that defective mind. That's how they became who they are. So you've got them talking, you know, and it's very hard for the rational to have a voice because the rational don't have giant followings. You know why? Because if you're a rational person throughout your life, you don't spend day in and day out trying to get as many followers as possible. That's not your bag. You're enjoying life. You realize that that is an Angry Birds type of lifestyle. It's a game. So unfortunately, we're only hearing from people who are defective to begin with.
But
he doesn't know who Joe Biden is.
Mike Pence can never be president, ever.
Why? He's nicer than Trump.
We might be screwed forever.
If you're just
hey
basing
guys,
it on his...
you're having fun. So check back in like
Red
a half
man,
hour.
Shut the fuck up, idiot.
We're doing live VR.
It sounds like you need some new mood.
I'm smoking weed and drinking.
Joe
We're
Rogan
going to my
supplement.
House right now. Ride Dune's here from...
It's almost over. I just want to see the whole thing.
All right. Oh, my God. We're all going to kill ourselves tonight. But anyways, Esther Koo's on her way. So we're going to have Esther Koo smoking weed, playing virtual reality. Let's do it. So check back on my Twitter in like 30 minutes. Twitter.com/Redband. R-E-D-B-A-N. We're going to have three different cameras and a bunch of sadness. Let's do it.
Three different cameras and a bunch
see
of
sadness.
Okay, that's Brian Redband. Okay, I have to pull us to break real quick because I have to pee very badly. It'll be like 2 seconds, and I'll be right back with Fool's Watch, Election Edition, the best meltdowns of the 2016 decision to put Darnell Tremp into office. We'll be right back. Test 1, 2.
No, doesn't
matter. Test 1, 2. What the fuck? Test 1, 2.
Wonka's got a new one today.
What is it?
This is called a scrumdiddlyumptious bar.
There we go. Coming back.
How does he do it?
My dear boy, do you ask a fish how it swims?
Sorry about that. Okay, we are back. It was one of those pieces where you're sitting there going, come on, let's go. Come on. You ever have one of those peas where it just keeps coming and coming and coming and you're on live and you got to go? Okay, so that was Brian Redband. Let's pull up. I want to show you Mike Bridenstine. So let's see if we can find him. Mike Bridenstine, he used to do the show all the time. You probably don't know him, but he's a comedian out in L.A. He's friends with all of them. And Mike Bridenstine has a black wife. Hashtag Black Wives Matter. But very similar to Bill Burr, he's got that kind of a black wife where you go, oh, that is 100% a black wife. You weren't fucking around there. It's not like he got some cute, you know, acne commercial type of black looking chick. He got a deep, dark abyss of a black, very nice. No, you know what? She's not a very nice woman. Let me tell you, can somebody pull up a picture of Mike Bridenstine and his black wife so I could show you? I would say, great person. You know, they all want to say she's so great. Let me tell you, the first time I met this girl, he comes over. Let's see, somebody's pulling it up for me right now. Sign my petition, Donald Trump, Red Band to change his name to Crying Bitch. Okay, I'll check that out in a sec. Somebody get me a picture of Mike Bridenstine and his black wife. And then I guess I'll pull up this link to his post, but we definitely got to show people the picture first so they understand the type of black we're dealing with here. Because it is a very, very severe, similar to Bill Burr's wife. Bill Burr's wife is jet. You know, she's not, and I think she's also like 67 years old, which is an odd, I just don't even know where they met. Let me find Mike Bridenstine's. You know, he blocked me on Facebook, so it makes it extra hard to find his exact Facebook message. But let's get a picture of him up in the meantime. I know there's like a 45-second delay, so that's why it takes a sec. Let me find his post first. You know, we've got thousands and thousands of screenshots and videos up at redbarradio.net/BBG. The Bring Back Group on Facebook. It's our official group. redbarradio.net/BBG. We'll take you right there. And we've been collecting all the best screenshots and videos from the meltdowns. So here he is, Mike Bridenstine. But I want that picture. Okay, let's see if we got a good one here. Says, no, Cameron, that link's not working. Guys, remember, I am banned from him on Facebook. So if you're sending me Facebook links, they are not going to work. That's why I need somebody to get a picture of her for me. Because I really don't want to go into this before. You got to see them. See them smiling. But yeah, Facebook will not work. He has banned me. And I'll show you why. Okay, while we wait for that, I'll read his post. I'm listening to my black wife sob to her mother. Before I unfriend every racist Trump fuck on here, I want you to sit in that. Fuck you. You're racist. Fuck you. This is what he says. Okay, here's him and his black wife. I need a better picture. You know, you got this one. She's wearing her Cubs hat. But yeah, she's playing peekaboo. And, but there are better pictures. She has a giant afro. I don't know why you would pick this one. So here she is. And Mike Bridenstine used to be cool. He used to be a fun guy. This wasn't him. He was never like this until this election started. Here's another one they're saying. Okay, let's see. Yeah, but you guys are still not showing me the afro stuff. You guys are picking some of the worst, but there's some of them where you can't even... It looks like a dark photoshopped thing that they put in there. Okay, but this isn't about being racist. It's about being real. You know, Mike Bridenstine, this is a normal guy. And then all of a sudden he shows up with this complete opposite. It's not about her being black. It's about him being such a complete opposite and this being so out of the blue. Cameron says, Mike sent you one in messages. Let's see. I don't see anything, Cameron. Oh, and okay, yeah. Here's their wedding photo. You know, this guy used to do the show all the time. He used to get it. He used to be a cool guy. So here's their wedding photo. I can't zoom in on this, but there it is. So, yeah, again, back to his post. I'm listening to my black wife sob to, and that's how he talks. I'm listening to my black wife sob to her mother. Before I unfriend every racist Trump fuck on here, I want you to sit in that. Fuck you. You're racist. Fuck you. And this was the type of tantrum that really caught our eye. It wasn't the disapproval. It wasn't even the worry. It was the complete breakdown of our adults, the people that we thought were adults. They literally can't. And, you know, to compare them to a child's tantrum, you know, we've heard this comparison so much that it doesn't really mean as much anymore. So it's kind of hard to articulate how childish they're acting because we use the word childish so often. But this is a genuine kid's tantrum. Like when your mom would just tell you no and you realized in your head that there was nothing you could do and you just broke down and then took it out on everybody around you because you didn't have a plan B. That's what we're seeing here with adults. I understand you could hate everything about this guy, but to write fuck you, you're racist, fuck you, and to want to unfriend friends that you've had for life. You know, I've been friends with this guy for 15 years. He sent me a message saying alt-right Mike and then blocked me. That's what he did. And meanwhile, let's go over this. I'm listening to my black wife sob to her mother. They want us to feel bad. Here's what you should be doing. If you're listening to that, Mike, you should go, everything okay? What are you crying about? Trump won! Yeah, you don't need to cry about that. That's how you be the man in a relationship. You don't go on Facebook and start unfriending everybody because your wife didn't get the memo that all of her fears are nonsense. I found her, they're saying, okay, a lot of Harambe pictures. I don't want to go there just yet, but yep, they're linking to me, Michelle Obama. But yeah, now what's so great about this is Bill Burr has the same exact kind of black wife, and this was Bill Burr's response. So let me show you this for just a second here. Remember, you went on Conan Abanin, and Bill Burr's response wasn't, fuck you, you're all racist, and to unfriend his friends. Why isn't Bill Burr's black wife? Oh, here's a good one. This is this guy, Mike Brennison's black wife. You know, you're going to post that and expect nobody to... I'm sure she... No, and you know what? When I keep saying I'm sure she's nice, this is how I first met this woman. We were doing a party in Los Angeles, okay? A Redbar party. And we were going to do a podcast at this party. And Mike Brennison came to the party. And he brought her for the first time, his black wife. And they came. And he introduced me to her. He goes, hi, Mike. This is my wife, blah, blah, blah. And she goes, hi. And she had this nasty look on her face. And I'm like, uh-huh. And then they started whispering to each other. And in front of everybody, Mike goes, if you want to go home, you can go, to his black wife. And she goes, yeah, I'm out of here. And he goes, I'll get you an Uber. And then he got his wife an Uber. Let me explain. She showed up to this party with us, and it's just whites. And they must have discussed this on the way here that, hey, if you don't like it, you could go home. She took one look at us and said, uh-uh. And sat there angry while waiting for her Uber and then left. That was how I met his wife. She came to our party, took a look around, said, mm-mm, which is cool. I respect that, by the way. That's badass. But don't at the same time make, I have to be like, oh, she's so great. She's so, that's how all his friends act. You are the best. She is amazing. You guys are the best couple. I treat people how they act. I treat people with respect. No, you get it. She acted like a bitch. That's all I know of her. She showed up to her party and went, I ain't hanging out here. And got back in the car and I said, you know, she has a giant afro. A little weird for you. Looks funny together. I'm not saying you should have. See, they would interpret that. They would be like, he's anti-mixed race. No. I'm still allowed to think this is funny. But let's watch Bill Burr. Because Bill Burr handled this a completely different way. And he's got just as black of a wife, if not blacker and more out of it. All right, let's check this out. Here he is, Bill Burr on Conan, that I'm about to pull up. It's one of these players, you know. Okay, here we go.
In the world,
Wait, I got to turn that Wonka music off. Okay, so here's Conan. Now, remember Conan during his monologue this very same night, in tears over the Trump win. This is really shaking him up. And then here comes Bill Burr, and he does this. I don't think Conan liked it.
Happening in the world. First question, everyone talking about voter turnout. Did you vote yesterday?
Yes, I did.
You did. Good for you.
Yes, I did.
Got a vote.
Yes, I did. I can't quite remember who I voted for president.
You don't like that.
It wasn't Trump or Hillary, though. Yeah. I didn't like either one of them.
Really? You didn't like either one?
No.
Okay, look at that. To me, if you didn't vote for Hillary, you're cool. But you got guys like this. Rogan did the same thing. Bill Burr didn't vote for Trump or Hillary. Now, in Conan's mind, and in the people who are crying's mind, if you didn't vote for Hillary, you're just as bad as a Trump supporter. People like Bill Burr and Joe Rogan are too rational to even know that these guys think that. So Bill Burr is openly on TV in front of Conan and Andy Richter going, yeah, I didn't vote for either of them. Not knowing that in Team Coco's Cone Zone, that is just as bad as voting for Trump, and he hates you. Conan is disgusted by Bill Burr. Bill Burr's sitting here being the same guy that he was last week, and the week before, and the week before that, and Conan can't get his head around it. So let's see that again and give this a watch here. Remember, same type of black wife, completely fine.
I can't quite remember who I voted for president. Uh-huh. It wasn't Trump or Hillary, though. Yeah. I didn't like either one of them.
Really? You didn't like either one?
No, I didn't. I couldn't stand her. She dresses like a real estate agent, like her doing this thing with her head.
Yeah.
The other guy's saying, take people's coats.
Yeah.
Conan ain't having it.
They just didn't offer.
He's pretending.
Yo, so they didn't appeal to you?
No, they didn't. And I don't understand why everybody's so upset.
Yeah.
You know, like, what's going to happen to you? If you liked Obama, did he call you at all in the last 8 years? Did he ever put a sandwich on your table? You do that. You're going to keep doing
that.
You're going to be fine.
Right.
Have you like, what's he going to? Oh, my God. Dude, I have to say, though, him winning is the most astounding thing I've ever seen.
It was a surprise.
He must have not watched Conan's monologue because Conan, he's mocking what Conan just did in the monologue. Somebody's saying Bill Burr equals cock. No. I thought so, too. But, you know, his black wife might have stepped in. But now Bill Burr is reactivated. Bill Burr has seen what's gone on, and now he's going, okay, I shouldn't have been what I've been this last year. I think it's time to get back to reality. Conan is gritting his teeth. Yeah, you can really tell how uncomfortable Conan is. Yeah, look at him. It really is astounding. Again, imagine if you actually truly believed what they believe. It would be scary. Like, imagine really thinking, man, you know, because as a person, I mean, me and you guys, we don't feel fear during the day ever. We wake up, nobody's scared. These people are waking up actually fearful, and we've got so many to go over. But let's watch Bill Burr just completely belittle everything that Conan said just moments ago.
Surprise! Dude, like, you're talking like Lake Placid. The Olympics, when we beat the Russian, buries that. Kurt Gibson's home run is a joke.
Right.
The Giants beating the undefeated Patriots, that's all a joke. Dude, the star of a reality show is going to run the country. The guy who decided if Bret Michaels or Cyndi Lauper would make a better CEO for a company that doesn't exist. It's going to be running stuff. It's unbelievable.
See, Bill Burr has to pepper in his actual thought with some Trump disses because the unstable, they need to You can't just be real. You can't just have a real conversation. So what Bill Burr's doing is going, and, you know, this orange-haired clown, because Conan needs that. Conan needs to hear that. Chelsea Handler needs to hear, oh, thank God he thinks he's a clown. They don't think that there's a way to have a discussion without doing that. And Bill Burr knows this. So he peppers that stuff in to appease them so that they keep listening.
Yeah.
He was the shit, though. He was like, he just reminded me like when I didn't read the book and I'm just like, just winging it, you know? I'm gonna do it. How are you going to do that? Oh, you'll see. You'll see. And it worked. Dude, he is the greatest shit talker of all time.
But what Bill Burr doesn't realize is people like Conan, people like Handler, people like Rep, they're not ready to even hear that he's the greatest at what he does. You know, when he won, I was saying the exact same thing. I go, this is, whether you hate him or love him, this is a phenomenal moment. You know, this guy had every single person against him. And he became the president of the United States through all of that. And we all watched it. And if you don't think that's incredible and inspiring, then you don't get it. So Bill Burr saying that same thing, they're not ready to hear that. They can't hear that. You know, they are not ready for any sort of reality.
Sat at like a $100,000 breakfast while the president trashed him. Humiliated.
This is a couple of years ago.
Yeah,
the,
I'm jumping around.
White House Correspondents' Dinner, yeah.
Thank you. Thanks for giving it structure.
Yeah.
Humiliated the guy.
Right.
My wife would love you. She should sit next to me during brunch.
Black
wife. She knows what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, the guy totally trashes him. He's absolutely humiliated. And within like 2-3 years, he had that guy's job.
Right.
So you could never talk shit to him. Going, hey, right. Hey, Donald, you know, one time I was in a bar and this guy came in, yada, yada. Oh, really? One time I was sitting, I paid $100,000 for breakfast. The President Trump, President, what the hell's his name? Barack?
Obama.
Yeah, Obama.
Yeah. I'm giving you structure now.
Conan
yeah.
Obama. Is mad.
He trashed me. 2 years later, I had a fucking job. I kicked him.
Fake laughing.
Out of his house. Yeah. Out of his house.
Well, how did you think the night would go? Did you?
I thought Hillary was going to kill him.
Yeah.
I totally did. I was sitting there going like, ah, you know, I mean,
isn't it nice to just hear a guy talk normal? And I know Bill Burr hasn't been the best over this year. You know, I thought we were losing him, too. We lost Louis completely. And I want everybody to know this. Stop watching Louis C.K.'s disgusting gay art project television show, Louis on FX. It is disgusting. If you like going to art museums with, you know, some Russian woman, you might enjoy his show. But if you don't, please stop watching it. Please stop saying he's genius. We lost Louis C.K. Louis C.K. used to be pretty cool. You remember him on Opie and Anthony? He was great. He's one of the bigger fools we have now. Somebody says Bill's Trump jokes are actually funny. I actually like hearing Bill Burr rip Trump because I know it's not coming from a place of insane cultism. Exactly. Just actually talking about the reality of the situation. Let's listen to more.
I thought he was going to do okay, but then it was unbelievable. It's like one of those things, like you're watching a game and you don't care who wins. You know what I mean? You just, I'm just hoping it's going to be a good game. And then all of a sudden, you know, one team's up by like 30, you're thinking, and he just came in.
And someone in the chat, I hate interrupting this because it's pretty good to hear. Cameron Malik in the chat. Well, Louis traps women and masturbates in front of them. So, yeah, it's true. I've heard that story. If you haven't heard this story about Louis, I've heard this story from many people. It could be completely fabricated, but I like to believe that it's true. And he's really never denied it. And remember when Louis left Twitter? Saying, oh, you know, I don't think it's good for people. He really left Twitter because he didn't want to get involved in this accusation. Because if somebody brought it up and he didn't answer, he would look guilty. And he knew he could never answer those accusations about masturbating in front of women. So I think he left Twitter as a way to make it so it's like, well, they can accuse me on Twitter and then I don't answer because I'm not on it. I didn't even see that. I think that's what his reasoning was. But the story is, and you hear this from a lot of female comics, is that back in the day, before he got super famous, Louis C.K. would take out his dick and start jacking. I get it. You know, he's drunk, he's horned, And in green rooms, like if he was on the road and there was female comics or some, or females in the room, he would just take it out, you know, drunkenly and just start jacking off. And people even said that he ran and blocked the door so a woman couldn't get out while he continued to jack off. And she was like, oh, what are you doing? What are you doing? And he's like, in some kind of. Those stories were around for a while. And I think Louis knew that it was going to get real bad on Twitter. And I think he knew, hey, if I just pretend I don't hear these stories, I won't have to be responsible for answering. Norton hasn't said who he voted for. I don't think. No, Norton is on our side. Louis went full retard. Louis is doing all this, try to get back in the favor of the production type friends that got him work. All you got to do is watch his show on FX and go, oh, he's that kind of guy. He's a little art project boy now. All right, back to Bill Burr. I hate cutting him off because he's got some great points.
I don't know. The Statue of Liberty. I don't know how he did it. It's astounding.
Are you worried about him at all being in office? Do you think, I mean, does it concern you?
I don't know. I feel like the president, you only see him like once every 3 weeks. You know? It'd be like if you were dating a chick and she was a jerk, but you only saw her once every 3 weeks. There's like no way she could break your heart, you know?
Trump. Look at Trump. What? I mean, not Conan.
No, you gotta see people. They're day to day.
Yeah? Well, what do you think his presidency is going to be like? You know, a forecast for us. What's it going to be like?
I have no idea. I have no idea. All I know is the other one used to go to those Bilderberg meetings, you know, where they all dress up like yaks and
he doesn't want to
eyes
hear
wide
that.
Shut parties. So I didn't know what she was going to do.
Wait, Hillary Clinton?
Oh, yeah.
What are you talking about?
That meeting they have underneath the mountain.
Look at this. In the chat, they go, Louis traps women and jerks in front of them. Lena Dunham raped her little sister. These people try to take the moral high ground. And another guy says, maybe that's why he became such a cuck. Self-preservation. Yeah. I think these people go out of their way. Because they have these twisted thoughts, and they assume that everybody is as twisted as them. We're not. We would never trap one. Actually, I've done that as a teen. I've jerked off in front of many people. I used to. That used to be my gag at teen parties. Not teen, but preteen parties. As soon as we learned about, I was always whipping it out at parties. But I had a big one back then. Ooh, was it long. It was so long. I remember I whipped it out at a party and a girl, this is one of my favorite moments to jack off to. There was a girl who went, oh my God. And she put her hands over her face and I whipped out my huge boner and she goes, oh my God. But then she kept going like this. Oh my God. But kept looking and pretending she was disgusted. And I'll never forget when she said this. She goes, how big is it?
Oh my God.
I jack off to that, the sound of her voice every day. It's a sickness. But, you know, the minute I turned normal, I stopped taking my dick out in front of people. Louis was doing this at age 36. And I think he's terrified that people will find out. So he's doing whatever he can subconsciously to be the best guy ever. The nation's hero. So that they will never believe his darkest secret, which is jacking off. And that is an insane dark secret. I actually demand Louis C.K. answer to this. You know, they got mad at Jimmy Fallon for not pressuring Trump when he had him on. How about the next time? Can you imagine if Jimmy Fallon pressured him?
So what is this about masturbating and locking people in?
just a dirty rumor. I've never done that.
You know, people saying you're masturbating. You know.
Imagine that on Fallon. What a show that would be. Oof. And we all saw Louis's butt on the show, Louis. That was a disaster. Wow. Louis has one of the worst bodies out there. What a complete failure. I love that Burr, even though Burr dresses really, really, really tacky, I love that Burr is doing this. Let's finish it up.
What are you talking? I brought you out here to bring perspective and knowledge at a painful time, and this is madness.
What do you mean
she dresses like a yak and meets under a mountain?
Look at Louis's
butt. What do you want me to say? Like, this whole thing, none of...
Conan's getting mad, but more importantly, somebody sent me... Where did it go? We just had Louis's tush on the screen. Here it is. Look at this. This is from Louis. Here's Louis naked getting into the bathtub. Look at that body. When this happened, I was shocked. Yeah, that is his ass. That is Louis's ass. And he thought, all my friends, all my fans, and everybody I've ever met in my life should see this moment. That's a sickness. He wanted to do this. It's very similar to Lena Dunham having one of the most disgusting bodies of all time and being naked all the time. Why would you want everybody you know? Listen, my body is not good, but it's nice enough where women can pleasure themselves to it. I would never get naked in front of nobody. It's embarrassing. And if Louis C.K. is embarrassed to get into a tub with this body, then there is a psychotic, what is it called? A disorder happening in his head. I'll just let you watch it getting into this tub over and over again. I get it. It's for a TV show. Would you ever do this for any amount of money? If someone came to you and said, I'll pay you $5,000. You get completely naked. You bend over in front of everybody you know, and you get into a tub. The only person who would do this is a sick, sick person. Look at Louis's body. Look at that ass. Jesus Christ. Oof. Imagine being on set. I can't look away. That is one of the best butts. You don't want your waist and love handles to be bigger than the butt. It's disgusting. All right, let's finish up Bill Burr. I haven't even been paying attention to Bill Burr, to be honest. What happened to him? Did I lose the video? I am getting a little whine. Okay, here it was. You know what? Fuck it with Bill Burr. We get it. He stands up for us. We have more fools to watch, and we have very little time. It's, we only have a half hour left here. Shout-outs for everyone coming out tonight. I want to remind people we have this Jack Buckby bonus show that we did. After our episode last week here, we went back to redbarradio.net. We did a bunch of bonus shows. They are gold. Check those out at redbarradio.net. And we also did this election special, a 10-hour. I divided it up into three parts. 10-hour, and I know you're over the election, but it's more of a show than straight-up election coverage, so I think that you'll get a lot out of that. It's all up at redbarradio.net, and for all the people confused, this is how we're going to do it, and we're still working things out. If you go over to redbarradio.net, every show we do will be on that front page, you know, in the newsfeed, in chronological order, whether it be a Cumias show, a bonus content show, or a regular Red Bar show. It's all there in order. From, you know, latest to oldest there. Not in the episodes tab, but on the news feed there. So whenever you're in doubt, just go to redbarradio.net and it will have every show in order up to date. We do encourage you to stay, follow all of these. It's a little messy right now. It's a little tough because we got an exclusive show on Cumia. Then we got our free show at redbarradio.net. But then we also have shows for our bonus content members, the Barmy. At redbarradio.net. So we hope that you join all of these things. We're trying to figure out a way to merge it all together so it's easy. But, you know, I'm only one man. So give it some time here. And we'll get to that. After show after this? Absolutely. There will be an after show after this at redbarradio.net. Not the longest one today because over the last week, you know, we've put up, I think, over 20 hours of content. In just about a week and a half. So we got to let people get caught up. I don't want to bury this stuff because I've said a lot of things that I want everybody to hear. So I don't know how long it'll be. Maybe just an hour today. I think I got a hot date with my wife. We're going to do some mutual masturbation over Skype. But let's get back to some of the fools. I know we have a lot of sick people to show you, and we'll be continuing this on today's after show at redbarradio.net. So when we end at Cumia in just a half hour, we'll be live at redbarradio.net, and you're all welcome to come on over and join along. I want to show you this. If you're coming from Cumia and you just met me, you probably don't know who this guy is, but this is Tommy NC2010. He's an autistic YouTuber that we've been following for a long time, and he's got a giant channel, 120 something thousand Subscribers, sorry, it's just the booze. I think I am coming down with a common cold from all this hatred this week. I wanted to show you Tommy's take. Now, if you don't know Tommy, don't worry about it. You'll find out about him in due time. But a lot of people, a lot of the Redbar guys know about him. So I want to show you his take on this election. A little different than all the other celebrities. Remember, this is a autistic man, a famous YouTuber, some of the most hilarious stuff. For those of you who don't know, I don't watch comedy television anymore. I get my laughs from real people. So I go on YouTube. I subscribe to these guys. I watch every vlog they put out. And when you start following these guys, you see this is better than any TV. These guys are actually providing, you know, the same awkward laughs as the team of writers is trying to recreate for shows like The Office and such. So I go right to the source. There is no need for a team of LA writers to try to concoct comedy when so much comedy is now available to us, real, and much more surprising and unpredictable than written comedy. You watch him, you never know what you're going to get. You know, you watch Brooklyn Nine-Nine, you're going to get a lot of horse shit. So here's Tommy's take on this whole election. A little bit different than the rest of the people
out there.
But,
you know, I stayed up late last night, watched the elections, and
this is not Melton, though.
I've been sleeping in this morning. I've been sleeping in today. I've been a naughty boy. I've been editing vlog 102, and I'm just exhausted, folks. I've been trying to get my energy back. I haven't left the apartment today, and
listen to his take, though.
I've just been here editing my vlog, and I decided to do this broadcast, and hope everybody has a lovely day. Remember, keeping you on the inside. Hold fact.
On, it's coming. Okay, he's drinking some of his juice.
But, yeah, congratulations to the new president of the United States. Congratulations to the people of this country. I'm going to do this is a short broadcast.
Isn't this funny? I need to play that again. So he says, but yeah, congratulations to the new president. Tommy, I hate to interrupt, but I think you're the only person saying that right now. But isn't that important? You know, it takes the autistic guy to remind us that Trump won the election. You know, half the country or half the voters wanted him. And when you turn on the mainstream news, you turn on any news, they're covering the Trump win like they covered the 9/11 tragedy, forgetting that while it's a tragedy for the 59 million people that voted for Hillary Clinton, it is not a tragedy to the 59 million people that voted for Trump. Yet every news station is covering it as a tragedy. What about how it's a great win for some people? So if you're not a Hillary supporter, you'd no longer have news. Yeah, you have Alex Jones, you got me, you got Gab. Okay, but mainstream news has officially let us know that they're not a news program for you. They cover Hillary's version of reality. Okay? Isn't that telling? Isn't that troubling? So we no longer have news for us. There is no congratulations, even though it was a tie, basically. There is only this is a tragedy. That should scare some people. You know, we always knew the media was, but now it's official. Because nobody is covering it as a win. They're only covering it as the glass half empty, the loss. So listen to Tommy again. Sometimes it takes an autistic person to remind us that half the country or half the voters wanted this. Listen.
But, yeah. Congratulations to the new president of the United States. Congratulations to the people of this country. I'm going to do this is a short broadcast. I'm not going to do it too long.
Congratulations to the people of this country. Remember that part of the whole president winning thing?
Subscribe, support, stay positive.
Stay positive. Here's a great comment in the chat. This fucking retard is smarter than Brian Redban. Absolutely. And this is Tommy NC 2010 on YouTube. Follow him, subscribe, and just watch here and there. You'll catch up, and it will be some of the best Fools TV you've ever seen. So there's Tommy, and I thought that was a very interesting take for him to go, congratulations, because we haven't heard that from anybody, right? Has anyone said congratulations? You know, and maybe that's not warranted, but it's funny that he just thinks it's a regular election. Let's see. So we got the Brian Redman thing. Oh, Grubhub. How much time do we got here? Okay, we got a little bit of time. Grubhub. I'm going to do this quick. I don't like reading these things. Grubhub has asked its employees that, you know, Grubhub, the food service. I'm actually banned from Grubhub. I'm one of the few people that are banned. We had years and years ago, I used to use Grubhub all the time. And we had a show. And 4chan was fucking with us at the time. They don't do it anymore because they learned right away, you know, that we're on their side. But they were fucking with us and they started ordering food to the studio here using Grubhub. And Grubhub had had so many fake orders that they banned my address completely. These weren't orders from me. They were from 4chan. And I called Grubhub. I said, hey, listen, you've blacklisted me. My address, my number doesn't work. And they said to me this. They said, bans are permanent. There's no way to reverse them. I go, yes, but I wasn't the one doing all this fake ordering. It was all these people. They were trolling me, you see. I'm sorry. Bans can't be reversed. This is what they said to me. And I go, okay. And now we have Postmates. We have DoorDash. And Grubhub hopefully is going the way of the gonzo. But Grubhub's CEO put out an announcement. And they basically said, if you don't agree with this email, if you don't agree with my statement, which is they hate Trump, they're anti-Trump. And I'm going to quote this. If you do not agree with this statement, then please notify to this email with your resignation because you have no place here. We do not tolerate hateful attitudes on our team. So now you have people working for these companies and they're losing their jobs because the CEOs hate Trump so much. They don't want any of their employees. If you voted for Trump, you're out. That's crazy, right? That's a little different than it's ever been. So yeah, this guy, I don't want to read this whole thing, but he wrote a long, whiny, complainy meltdown email to all of his employees. And he said, if you're a Trump supporter, we want your resignation. You have no place here. That's Grubhub. So if you hate this kind of nonsense, no more Grubhub. Do not use Grubhub anymore. Let's see. Grubhub's App Store reviews plummeted after CEO's anti-Trump memo, they're saying. Yeah. Yeah, use DoorDash, use Postmates. But, you know, this is what we were dealing with when we got kicked off YouTube. Back with that Amy Miller stuff. Our show was banned from YouTube. And people go, how do you get banned from YouTube? There's so much crazy shit on there. Exactly. But it was called to their attention. And ultimately, these people make the decisions. And these people are part of that whole left bubble. So this is what's happening. No wonder people didn't want to admit they were voting for Trump. You still can't. If you're a normal person, you know me, I got nothing to worry about. The only person I work with is one of the most pro-Trump people on this planet, our king, King Cumias. All hail Anthony Cumias. Imagine if Hillary would have won. This would have been a dismal network, but our network is basically in charge. You know what they said? Compound Media now is now required grade school listening. So in the morning, instead of the Pledge of Allegiance over the intercom, comes the Compound Media's shows because we're in charge now. But yeah, imagine if you were a normal person. You can't admit this. And that was part of the whole process. This is what got people, this type of peer pressure is what got people to be so against Trump. You know, most people don't want to be ostracized from, you know, everything they're a part of. So it's very easy. I mean, a weak person is very easily influenced by stuff like this, and they just You see it with Bert Kreischer. Bert Kreischer is on both sides. It's so funny because you see Joe Rogan talk to Bert Kreischer and he's like, these people are carrying on like babies, huh? Complaining about the Trump one. And Bert Kreischer's like, yeah, they are being babies. But when Bert Kreischer's around his liberal friends, he's like, this guy's such a clown, man. Because he don't know. You know, they're all bullied into follow the leader. And that's Grubhub. So don't use Grubhub anymore. I've been banned for years. And I have found many ways around it. And I'm fine. So no more Grubhub. Lots of different services out there. All right, I want to show you some of the more faggoty ones because we really, I thought, you know, time went by so fast. I mean, it spent too much time on some of the other ones. Let me find my master list again. Oh, before we go, we have a giant announcement coming up next week. A giant announcement. Actually, no, coming up Wednesday. We have a giant announcement for all people that are fans of Redbar. You're going to want to hear this one. Another announcement coming up. Another big win. So stay tuned for Wednesday. Huge, huge announcement about the future of this show coming up. Hold on. I am getting a little too crunker, but I'm trying to find our Facebook thread again on the Bring Back group with all the greatest posts. Give me 1 second. We really didn't get anywhere with these. I have like thousands and thousands of videos to show you guys. We'll have to do them on the after show. But I want to go through these people's Twitters. I mean, this is what we've been wanting from all of these people that we hate so much for so long, and now they're finally doing it. So regardless of politics, I hope you don't think of this as a political-inspired episode today. I hope you understand that this is, you know, exactly what Redbar has always been about. So hold on. I'm trying to pull up this thread. This thread is so long. We've got 176 entries on this thread in our group on Facebook. This is Bring Back Redbar Radio on Facebook. You could join this group. You got to be a fan of the show. You got to like the show to be a part of the group. We're not interested if you're out to hate me to be in this group. Redbarradio.net/BBG. And I'm trying to open this thread, but it's so heavy right now. Because I want to show you some of the best. There's this comedian, Rhea Butcher, that really went out of her way to say some dangerous shit. Don't try to guess our announcement. And no, I'm not moving to New York. It's not that great. Sorry, guys. I'm trying to open this up. This page is going very slow for me. And I am getting kind of dizzy off this wine. I think I am getting sick from staying up and not getting enough sleep over this election. Oh, they're really laying into Pete Davidson, the Photoshops. Yeah, so the group is where you go to kind of, we talk about all these fools in more depth, and we post Photoshops of them and come up with ways to bother them. What I've been doing just secretly to myself, you know, shit posting is back. I was talking to Sven about it. And this Trump win has, you know, they fear, oh, this Trump win has really set the tone. It kind of has. Because all the people like me who have been so upset over the years with all their rules and the PC stuff, we do feel free to shit post now. Like I caught myself on Instagram a couple times, people who are so upset about this. And what I've been doing is playing dumb and commenting like, wait, you're a Trump supporter? What the fuck? And then they go mad. So yeah, if you see a liberal on Instagram post some anti-Trump stuff, pretend that you're misinterpreting it and comment, wow, you're a Trump supporter? Dude, disgusting. And then they'll comment back, what the fuck? No, I am not a Trump. It's their biggest fear to be mistaken even for a Trump supporter. So that's the best thing you could do to all these people. Pretend to mistake them as Trump supporters publicly. They panic and they scramble to correct you. And then reply to that with still not getting the idea and be like, okay, whatever. Then why did you vote for him? They don't know what to do. It's their biggest fear to be looked at amongst their peers as a Trump supporter. Okay, I think I finally got this thread open here with some of the best responses. And I want to find this Rhea Butcher. She is Cameron Esposito's girlfriend. This is a popular lesbian comedy couple, and they're just starting to pick up a lot of steam. And I really want to show you. Okay, here's the best one, and we read this on election night. Here's Rhea Butcher. Her girlfriend is Cameron Esposito. I think they're married. They're comedians in L.A. Cameron Esposito, she's getting pretty big right now. And this is her wife. I'm in bed right now with my wife, rattled with fear and pain, wondering how much longer she will legally be my wife. These are the kind of messages they're putting out to their followers who are weaker than them. When did you ever hear anything about Trump breaking up gay people's marriages? When was that ever even discussed? I'm in bed with my wife, rattled with fear and pain, wondering how much longer she will legally be my wife. And if you go to her Twitter feed, it's countless posts like this. She really believes Trump is going to come take that ring off her finger and throw it into the ocean. You're not married anymore. What person would ever do that? Even the worst guy in the world wouldn't do something like that. So if you truly, truly believe that's happening, the only thing I could think of is that you're completely insane and you shouldn't be talking to people. Let's see, Jamie Kilstein. Here we go. We're going to just go through these on the feed. Trump voters act like these brave alpha males, but you are scared. Scared of women, of brown people, of change. You're cowards. Doesn't even sound like anything crazy anymore to say that. Oh, I wanted to bring this up. Do you remember when Kanye West got on live TV with Michael Myers and said, George Bush doesn't care about black people? Do you remember that? Do you remember, if you're old enough to remember, do you remember the response to that? People gasped. Everybody gasped. The liberals, people on the right, everybody. When Kanye West said, George Bush doesn't care about black people, I cannot believe he said that on TV. Can you believe? It wasn't that long ago. We were doing Redbar when that happened. We covered it on Redbar. Now, that is the celebrity norm. Imagine if somebody said, Donald Trump doesn't care about black people. Nobody would even play that. They would go, yeah, he doesn't. Yeah, everyone says that. But back then, you had George Bush. He was far worse than Donald Trump in many ways. I mean, George Bush is a scary guy. You got to be worried about the Christian psychopaths more than... Donald Trump guy is more like me. George Bush is more like secret society, evil. You know, it's okay to hate him, but when Kanye West said George Bush didn't care about black people, people were shocked. They'd never heard anything like that. And now you cut to today. Nobody would even repost something like that. That's just what they're saying about Trump. Everybody says that about Trump. Isn't that crazy? I mean, that was a big deal. Well, Kanye West said that there was like 8 months of going over that clip. People could not believe it. And now that is just the norm. And I was going to say, so with this Jamie Kilstein post, he posted this right after the election, and I thought it was pretty crazy. This is normal now. Trump voters act like these brave alpha males, but you were scared. Scared of women? Scared of people? Of change? Saying stuff like that now sounds just normal. Oh, yeah, that's what Hillary people say. You're scared of women. We need to remember how insane that message is. It's getting so normalized that half of the country is scared of women, and that's why this all happened. Nobody is scared of women. If anything, we just know more about women. So let's not let this become so normalized. This is insane behavior. Mike Bridenstine, here's more from that guy, Mike Bridenstine. Listen to what he's writing to his followers. I'm sorry, this page is going really slow. Silly me and my liberal LA bubble. I didn't think we'd follow the first black president with the KKK. The KKK. Let me tell you something. You know, the KKK is made up of human beings. And I'm not defending these monsters by any means. These are the tackiest people on the planet. But did you think the KKK never voted in presidential elections before Donald Trump? You know, there's only two choices, and the KKK is probably going to vote for one of them. So you can't really use them as an example. You know, the KKK, watch all of your movies too, celebrities. And you don't seem to mind there. You know, the KKK do everything that people do, and that includes vote. So you can't really say that, you know, because any movie that has ever made money has been watched by the KKK. You think they don't watch Judd Apatow movies or Transformers? What do you think the KKK watches? Just one movie? Some old talkies? What do you think they watch? Listen, the celebrities who have complained have taken more money from the KKK than Donald Trump ever has. Trust me on that. They've been collecting from the world's racists their entire lives. You know, California wants to Brexit and cut themselves off. Do they understand the only reason they're making any money at all is because of all these red states? Those are the people who buy their shitty fucking movies. So if you want to Brexit, how about this? You don't let the people who vote for Trump watch your movies. How about that? Would you take that pay cut? Would you do that? Judd Apatow? You know, how do you, and this is what I never understood. You know, obviously these people, only care about money. It amazes me. Okay, Sony Pictures, for instance. Sony Pictures is afraid to say the word faggot because they don't want to lose people, right? You wouldn't want to find the president of Sony Pictures saying the word faggot. Why? Because he doesn't want to lose people because it's a business. But they have no problem telling half the country to go fuck themselves. You would think that's a little bit bigger of a business than the people who are going to be offended by the word faggot. It's really weird. And I wonder if this will, it won't cut away at business, because you know what? The people who support Trump, they don't care. They're not going to picket, and they're not going to stop enjoying movies because these people have different views than us. It's just a little bizarre. The KKK is entirely made of the FBI. There's only 10,000 people in the KKK. It ain't real. Exactly. You know, that's more my point. But all these people who are outraged that the KKK supports Trump, the KKK supports everything that's available in the marketplace. And believe me, the KKK have paid to see these people's movies. Do you think KKK only steal movies? Maybe. Maybe they're all torrenters. But I doubt it. Katy Perry. No, we've done her. T.J. Miller said a bunch of crazy shit. Let's see what else we got. We don't have much time here. We got to wrap up soon. Amy Schumer has still not made an official statement yet. Amy Schumer has gone silent, more or less. I think she's posted some pictures, but here's what I have to say to Amy Schumer. You have campaigned. You have made us watch all of these videos, and you have shamed people into voting all year. You can't come up with something to say to all these people that wasted their time. You're supposed to be their hero. You can't come up with a few lines of text, you know, something positive, something motivating for all of these people that you've led into the abyss. That's despicable. Same thing with Hillary Clinton. You're going to go MIA. You couldn't stay up for two more hours for all these people who wasted years of their life campaigning for you. That's despicable. And it should be very telling on the type of people they are. You know, we got to wrap up here. We're going to continue. We're going to do some after show here. I do feel like I am getting sick, so it's not going to be a very long. But we will be back. Thank you for coming out. Please check out all that we've got to offer at redbarradio.net. And what's it called? And join the Barmy. redbarradio.net/Barmy. It's our full bonus content club. It's also got the archives that date back to 2003. Let's merge the universes. We'll be right back for a Barmy-only show, but you guys are welcome to join live at redbarradio.tv. So I'm going to take a break. I'm going to upload today's show to Compound Media so that we could get it up for people right away, because last week we didn't do that. And then I'll be back in about 5 to 6 minutes with some after show on redbarradio.tv. We hope to see you there soon. We had a great time. Much more to go over here. As we look through all these fools on Facebook and Twitter. We're going over all the shit they posted. It ain't ending anytime soon. We'll see you guys later. Thanks for coming out. Ooh, hooroo, white power, fuck Redbar. We'll see you guys soon. Redbarradio.tv. My eyes are burning. I know I'm getting sick. Doesn't matter, we're gonna still stay up. We'll see you soon. This isn't the best ending song, I'll tell you that.
Up the airy mountain, down the rushing glen, we dare not go a-hunting for fear of little men. You see, nobody ever goes in.